Welcome friends, in this video we will discuss about linear transformation. We know that a mapping T is a homomorphism from vector space V into the vector space W if it satisfies the two conditions T of V1 plus V2 equal to T of V1 plus T of V2, and the second condition alpha times V T of V equal to alpha times T of V, then this T is called as a homomorphism. It is also called as a linear transformation. T is called a linear transformation. Linear transformation. This is linear transformation. Now we show that the set of homomorphism satisfies few properties. Here we discuss about few properties of this linear transformation. That is, this is a set V, this is a set W, then the set of all linear transformation is also a vector space. We have proved this. This is also a vector space. Now we show that this set here, we take linear transformation over the same vector. Instead of W, we consider it as a set V and consider the set of homomorphism from V into the set V, and we show that the elements of this set homomorphism from vector space V into the vector space V satisfies certain properties. Let us suppose that I have two element T1 and T2 belongs to the set of homomorphism from vector space V into the vector space V. Now we define how to multiply this T1, T2. Let us see the definition of this. T1, T2 of V equal to T2 of T1 of V. This is the definition of multiplication. Now we show that this T1 into T2 is also a linear transformation. That is, for alpha comma beta belongs to F, and for u comma v belongs to v, this vector satisfies the condition of homomorphism, that is T of alpha u plus beta v, this is equal to alpha times T of v plus beta times T of u beta times T of v. This condition of homomorphism or linear transformation satisfy T1 into T2. These are the two conditions of linear transformation which are combined into single condition T of alpha u plus beta v equal to alpha times T of u plus beta times T of v. Now we show that this condition is satisfied by combined mapping T1 into T2. So let us take alpha u plus beta v, T1 T2 of alpha u plus beta v equal to, by definition this is equal to T2 of T1 of alpha u plus beta v. So this is equal to, but T1 is linear transformation, so this is alpha times T1 of u plus beta times T1 of V, and this is under the mapping T2. But T1 of U is a element of V, it is another vector, that is W1, and T1 of V is another vector, W2 suppose. So this is like alpha into W1 plus beta into W2, T2 of, but T2 is a linear transformation, so this is equal to alpha time t2 of w1. Alpha time t2 of w1 means what is w1 here? T of u1, t1 of u plus beta times t2 of w2. What is t2 of w2? This is t1 of v. Now look at this term, t2 of t1 of u. This is nothing but alpha times t1 t2 of u, t1 into t2 of u plus beta times t1 into t2 of v. So the condition of homomorphism or linear transformation is satisfied by the mapping t1 into t2, and hence t1 into t2 is also a linear transformation. Here see that we are talking about the set of homomorphism from vector space V into the vector space V. Now we show that if we have three mapping, then this also satisfies the conditions of associativity. Here we have defined t1 t2 of V equal to t2 of t1 of V. This is the definition of linear transformation, t1 into t2. Okay, now let us see the associative property. What is associative property? For t1 into t2 comma t3 belongs to the set of homomorphism from vector space V into the vector space V, and any element V belongs to capital V. We prove that t3 into t1 plus t2, this is equal to t3 into t1 plus t3 into t2. So see here, t3 of t3 into t1 plus t2 of V equal to, this is new mapping, suppose this is S, this is like t into S, and we have defined how to operate this t1 into t2 on V. This is equal to t1 plus t2 of t3 of V, t1 plus t2 of t3 of V. Okay, and we also know that the definition of S plus t of V equal to S of V plus t of V. So by that definition, we can write this as t1 of t3 of V plus t2 of t3 of V. Okay, now see, this is nothing but t3 t1 of V plus this is t3 t2 of V. This is equal to t3 t1 plus t3 t2 of V. Okay, so this gives that t3 into t1 plus t2 equal to t3 into t1 plus t3 into t2. That is, left distributive property is satisfied. Now the question is, satisfies the right distributive property. What will be the right distributive property? That is, if we have t1 plus t2 and multiplied by t3, then it should be like this: t1 plus t2 into t3, this is equal to t1 into t3 plus t2 into t3. Now let us take its image, t1 plus t2 into t3 of V. Okay, this is a mapping S. Then apply the product definition. This is S of V, t3 of, t3 of S of V. So this is t1 plus t2 of V. Okay, now applying the combined definition of S plus t of V, this is t1 of V plus t2 of V under t3. So this is equal to, again t3 is a linear transformation, so this is t3 of t1 of V plus this is T3 of T2 of V. Now by the product definition, this is equal to T1 T3 plus T2 T3. This is equal to T1 T3 plus T2 T3 of V. Okay, so we get that the here the left right distributive property is also satisfied. Now what about the multiplicative associativity? Multiplicative associative property of, that is multiplicative associative, here T1 into T2 into T3, this should be T1 into T2 into T3, like this. So let us prove this property. T1 into T2 into T3 of V equal to, apply the definition, this is my S, so this is T into S, this is equal to S of, that is T2 into T3 of, T2 into T3 of T1 of V. Again this is product mapping, so this is T3 of T2 of T1 of V. But in this parenthesis we can write this as a T1 into T2 of T3. Okay, so this is my mapping S. Hence I can write here, this is equal to T1 into T2 into T3 of V. Okay, so you can see that this is T1 into T2 into T3 equal to, first preference goes to the parenthesis and we get that the associative property with respect to multiplication is satisfied. Now let us see another property of scalar multiplication to the mapping. Let us take the image of the element under the multiplication alpha times T1 into T2. Alpha times T1 into T2, this is my mapping S, so this is like alpha S. Then by definition, here lambda S of V equal to lambda times S of V. So we can apply this definition, this is equal to alpha times T1 T2 of V. Alpha times T1 T2 of V, this is alpha times, by definition this is T1 of T2 of T1 of V. Okay, now if my alpha is like this, alpha into T1 into T2, this is equal to, this is S suppose, then this is S into T, apply the definition S into T. So first apply T2 and then apply, this is equal to alpha T1 of V, alpha T1 of V, then this is alpha times T1 of V and this is under T2, this is like a element W, so this will be alpha into T2 of T1 of V, alpha into T2 of T1 of V. Now again if we consider this as a T1 into alpha times T2, this is a T and this is S, then by definition this is equal to alpha T2 of T1 of V equal to, okay, so this is again an element W, so this is alpha T2 of W, hence it is equal to alpha times T2 of T1 of V. Now look at these three, this is equation number 1, this is equation number 2 and here this is equation number 2 and this is equation number 3. And you can see that all these three equations, right hand side of equation 1, equation 2 and equation 3 are equal. So left hand side of these three equations are also equal. And in the left side we can see that we get that alpha into t1 into t2 equal to alpha t1 into t2 equal to t1 into alpha t2. Okay, so this condition is satisfied here in this set of homomorphism from vector space v into v to v. Okay, now let us define. So an associative ring A is called an algebra, a ring R with two binary operation plus and dot. With plus operation it is an abelian group, already it is an abelian group, but it satisfies, if it satisfies these three additional property, it's called as addition associative ring. And in vector space we A is a vector space, okay, but it has a three additional properties, this first closure, second associative and three distributive over a field F. Okay, when this is an associative ring and a vector space with this condition alpha times ab equal to alpha a into b equal to alpha in a into alpha b, if these three conditions are satisfied, then this a is called as an algebra. Now we have seen that a set of homomorphism from a vector space v into v, or linear transformation from vector space v into v, we denote this set by A of v. And to trace the field, sometime we write it as a suffix f over v. A of v is nothing but a set of homomorphism or set of linear transformation from vector space v into a vector space v. Then we prove one lemma regarding this associative ring and the set of homomorphism. What is an associative ring? Associative ring A is an algebra. A is algebra if condition alpha times AB equal to alpha A into B equal to A into alpha B, this condition is satisfied, and the set of homomorphism from vector space V into V is denoted by A of V. Now we show that here the statement of lemma is that if A is an algebra with unit element, then this A is isomorphic to a sub algebra of A of V for some vector space V over F. This is a lemma. A is an algebra with a unit element, then A is isomorphic to a sub algebra of A of V for some vector space V over. Through this lemma, first we consider if we have an element A, small a belongs to capital A, and T suffix A is a mapping from vector space V into the vector space A into the vector A, algebra A to the algebra A, where for any V belongs to capital A, this mappings T suffix A of V equal to V into A. Then now we show that this T A is nothing but a linear transformation. It satisfies the two conditions of linear transformation. Suppose V1 comma V2 are any two elements of the algebra, then T A of V1 plus V2 equal to T A of V1 plus V2 equal to V1 plus V2 into A. This is equal to V1 of A plus V2 of A. But V1 of A is nothing but T suffix A of V1 plus T suffix A of V2. And third, alpha V, T suffix A of alpha V equal to alpha V into A. Again, A is algebra, so we write this as alpha times V A. This is equal to alpha times T V A means this is nothing but T suffix A of V. So this T A, this shows that this T A is linear transformation. T A is linear transformation. Now let us obtain the T suffix alpha A plus beta B. Let us see that. Let us calculate another mapping T suffix alpha A plus beta B, where alpha comma beta are scalar elements of A and A comma B are elements of algebra A. Then by definition, this is equal to V into alpha A plus beta B. This is equal to this is nothing but alpha times V A plus beta times V B. Okay, this is equal to alpha times V A. V A means T suffix A of V plus beta into T suffix V, T suffix B of V. Now by definition, this is alpha T suffix A. We have applied the definition of mapping a homomorphic linear transformation, that is lambda S of V. Lambda S of V equal to lambda times S of V. So here, the instead of S, if we write it as a T A, we get T A of V, T suffix A of V, lambda equal to. So this must be equal to, this is equal to beta times T B of V. This is equal to, here is a V, my V, and here alpha T suffix A plus beta T suffix B, right? So you can see that here T alpha A plus beta B equal to, we get alpha times T A plus beta times T B. Now then T suffix A into B of V equal to, by definition, V into A B. Again, these are all elements of algebra, so this is equal to first multiply this V by A and then B. Okay, so this is my W, then this is T suffix B of W, right? But V A means this is T suffix A of V, right? Now this is T1 into T2 of V. This is same as T A into T B. So we get that here T suffix A B equal to T A into T B. Now look at this. We have these another properties of T A. By definition of T A, what is definition of T A? T A of V, T A of V equal to. So see here what we have shown, that firstly we have defined a mapping T suffix A, and the definition of T suffix A definition, by definition of T suffix A. What is the definition of T suffix A? T suffix A of V equal to V into A. Then we get that T suffix alpha A plus beta B equal to alpha times T suffix A plus beta times T suffix B. And third, T A suffix B equal to T A into T B. This is we get. Now we show that consider a mapping from a vector space. From a vector space, psi is a mapping, suppose, from algebra A to A of V. Okay, A of V from, since what is A of V? Here, A of V from vector space V into vector space V. So we have defined this TA is a linear transformation over the algebra A into A. So TA is an element of A of V. A of V. It is a particular type of set, a particular type of mappings A, and here A is algebra, this is my set A. We are defining this mapping psi, this is a whole set A of V, and these are the particular type of subset of this set, okay, such that we are defining for A psi of A equal to T suffix A. This is A, then there is a mapping T suffix A. Now you can see that alpha A plus beta B, psi of alpha A plus beta B, by definition T psi of A equal to T A. So this is equal to T suffix alpha A plus beta B, but this is equal to alpha into T A plus beta into T B, but this is equal to alpha into T A means psi of A plus beta into T B means psi of B. Again, al A into B, psi of A into B, this is equal to T suffix AB, this is equal to T A into T B, this is equal to psi of A into psi of B. So this shows that this mapping psi is a ring homomorphism, ring homomorphism, right? So condition of homomorphism is satisfied by this mapping psi. Now we show that the kernel of this psi consists of only zero element, then there will be isomorphism from a vector space from algebra A into the A of V, that is a subset of A of V, which consists of T A, right? So let us take, suppose that A is an element, A belongs to capital A, is in the kernel of psi, is kernel of psi, therefore the psi of A equal to 0. But psi of A is, this implies that what is psi of A? This is T A equal to 0. T A is, this is a T A, T A equal to 0, therefore 0 mapping, and hence we have that this is T A of V equal to 0 for all V belongs to capital A. But A consists of unit element. A has a unit element, has unit element. So that element is suppose E. Then this T A of T suffix A of E equal to 0. Apply the definition of T A. This is nothing but A into E equal to 0. But A is a E is a unit element, so this implies that A equal to 0. Hence this kernel of psi consists of zero element only, and therefore this mapping psi is an isomorphism. Psi is an isomorphism to A into A of V, so that this algebra A is isomorphic to a subset of T, subset of A of V.